Hello everybody, today I'm here to do a tag. This is the Montgomery May tag for the Montgomery May Readathon, and it's based around the heroines of LM Montgomery's novels, or a bunch of her novels at least. I do have a computer right here that I'll be reading from, and then some answers and things written down, so if I'm not looking at you or at my phone, then that is why. So I'm going to get into this and talk through some of my answers. So the first question is for Anne from Anne of Green Gables. So Anne is an orphan who has long wished for a family of her own and a place to belong. Share a book that has a heartwarming found family element. And I decided to mention the Insignia trilogy by S.J. Kincaid. So these are science fiction, young adult novels that kind of focus on a young boy. I think he's like 14 when the story starts, and they focus on him being kind of taken into this government training program that has to do with a war that's going on between these different factions in the world. So it's kind of futuristic dystopian science fiction, and Tom, our main character, meets some friends when he gets there. He's kind of been a loner because he is living with his dad, who is mostly making his money by gambling and things in casinos. So they're always bouncing around. He's never really in school and things very much. So he gets recruited into this program because he does video games. And so he's recruited into this program. And so it's about him finding out what's going on and also meeting some friends and the bond that they develop. And I really love the aspect of that friendship and that family aspect as they kind of come together throughout the entirety of this trilogy. It's really fantastic and a series that I would recommend. The next question is about Emily. So Emily of New Moon. Emily was the character that LM Montgomery said was the most like herself. Which literary character do you most identify with? So there's a lot of characters that I could say for this, because I think that I relate to a lot of aspects of different characters. But the one I'm going to mention right now is Kaladin from the Stormlight Archive series by Brandon Sanderson. And so Kaladin in the story is a slave in the beginning of the story, and we see his journey, how he became a slave, and then kind of what happens with him in his slavery. And he has a very tough life. I do not relate in the fact that I'm not a slave, thank goodness, but Kaladin has a lot of problems with depression and has always kind of lived with this kind of bleak mindset as far as, you know, he just can't keep a positive mood for very long. He also feels extremely responsible for everybody around him, and so he is always trying to help people, but he has a hard time kind of opening up to more people. So he gets like a group of people and he becomes very close to those people, but it's hard for him to open up outside of that. And so those aspects of his character I relate with a lot because of like the depression and just kind of the cyclic aspect of his depression is relatable to me, as well as like the difficulty I have with opening up to large groups of people because I get exhausted easily. And it's not just like an introverted thing. Yes, I'm quite introverted, but it also just feels like I'm giving all of myself away if I am communicating with lots of people. So it can be a challenge for me to have like large friend groups and things like that. So one reason that I'm not always the best about communicating with people online, because it's just extremely exhausting for me. And so I can relate to his character in that respect. Rilla from Rilla of Ingleside. So Rilla's story takes place during World War I. What's a major world event that has taken place during your lifetime? And recommend a book that includes that event in some way. So this is actually my favorite LM Montgomery book, Rilla of Ingleside. And I'm going to talk about 9/11. So September 11th, 2001, I was 10 years old when the towers in New York City were attacked and destroyed. And I remember watching the news and seeing some of this happen, like the second tower being hit and the towers falling. And so I have memories of that having happened when I was younger. And then I read the book, The Only Plane in the Sky. Can't remember the author's name, but I'll put it up here. I'll put the cover up here. But I remember reading this book and just being fascinated by, the different aspects he showed. So this is kind of like an oral history where he talked to a bunch of different people, and it was interesting to look at different perspectives, like all of the people from different parts of the country and some of the people who were in the towers and the people who were there on the ground in nearby areas and just kind of the chaos of the time. And so it was interesting to read this perspective and also to see kind of how some of these people, because this is a more recent book, and so some of them have been able to give, thoughts more recently, and seeing how it has affected their lives, things that might have happened to them, some of the people who survived in the towers, and how they have kind of coped with having dealt with this situation. So that one is an interesting one. Kilmeny of the Orchard. So Kilmeny loves to play the violin. How does music play a role in your life? Like, do you play an instrument? Songs that mean a lot to you? Anything you kind of want to do with this? And I don't play any instruments. I would love to sing, but I don't think I really have a voice for singing. Maybe one day I'll take singing lessons. But I love listening to music. And when I was younger, I wanted to be a musician. And I think a lot of that goes along with my storytelling. I'm a writer. I've always thought that, writing and singing and playing music and acting, all of those are things that I have been drawn to in my life. And I think that it all comes back to that storytelling aspect. But about this question more specifically, their music is kind of a therapeutic thing for me. I love to listen to music and connecting with lyrics. So usually it is the lyrics in a song that I connect with the most. And then obviously voices and things and instrumentation play a lot into it as well. So some of the singers and musicians that I have connected with most over my life, so David Cook, who I've been to see in concert several times and will hopefully be going to see again very soon. He's a big one. I have loved a lot of his songs and listened to them quite a lot. Shinedown, I've been listening to their music for close to 20 years now, so I really love them and a lot of their songs that they've released more recently, being so focused on like mental health and that type of thing has been great. I've recently discovered NF, so he's mostly does rap music and he's been around for quite a while, but I only recently discovered him and he has some really beautiful songs that kind of in a lot of ways deal with his own healing from various traumatic events in his life. And so I've really enjoyed getting to know his music. Rin from YouTube sensation in the past few months. So if you see any like music reactors, they've probably reacted to Rin. And he's done several songs that I've really connected with. Particularly though, he has two songs that he did with Chinchilla, and they're called How to Be Me and then Chalk Outlines, and those two I really connect with in a lot of ways, and I really appreciate the messages incorporated into them. So those are very good. Breaking Benjamin is another one. I love Ben Burnley's voice, and I've been listening to them for decades at this point, and really just love his voice and just a way that a lot of their music is presented. So music is a very big part of my life as far as listening to music, and yeah, probably will continue to be so, maybe even more so. I've gotten more into music again in the past few months. Next question is about the story girl. So Sara from the story girl loves to tell stories to anyone who will listen. Share a short story collection that you love. And I actually have, where is it? I have a collection of Dostoevsky short stories. Oh, they're up here. It's So I have this collection of Dostoevsky's short stories, and they have some fantastic ones. The Dream of a Ridiculous Man, I think, is my favorite Dostoevsky short story. I just find it so fascinating. But there's also some other good ones, like Bobok is quite entertaining. A Novel in Nine Letters, which is a short one, is really entertaining. So there's some great ones in there. Pat from Pat of Silver Bush. So Pat is a homebody. She loves her home and her family and has no desire to ever leave them. What does home mean to you? Is there a literary home you would love to live in? So I think home for me is a place that you can kind of be yourself and somewhere you can feel safe and that you can relax. You don't have to have any barriers and that type of thing. So I think that that is home to me. And as far as literary homes that I would like to live in, I would actually love to live at Drondel Fields with the Pickerings. So they are from Michael J. Sullivan's Rhaenyra series. So Rhaenyra Revelations and Rhaenyra Chronicles, they're in both of those. And so the Pickerings are a family within there, and they live at this place called Drondel Fields. And there's just something about their family that makes me happy, and I would just love to live with them in Drondel Fields and be happy. So that's one. Valancy from the Blue Castle. Valancy is a character who longs to push past family pressures and expectations and carve out her own path to find happiness. What's a book that inspired you to overcome difficulty in your life? I'm going to mention one in the past few years here that I've read is Unbroken by Laura Hillenbrand. And this is about Louis Zamperini, who was an Olympic athlete. He was a track star in the early 1900s into the 1930s, and then was in World War II and ended up being in a Japanese prisoner of war camp for a long time. And I just find him extremely inspiring as a person, and I'm glad that she presented his story in the way that she did because it made him easy to connect with. We got to see all of this hardship and these struggles that he went through, but ultimately we also saw him embracing Christianity and his beliefs kind of saving him from the downward spiral that he was in, and him overcoming all of these struggles that he had, like with PTSD and alcoholism brought on from that PTSD. So we get to see him kind of overcoming these struggles, and all of that's presented in that book. And I find it very uplifting and encouraging in life to see somebody who has faced so much and did so much good in his life, the remainder of his life, and was very forgiving, was able to forgive people who had done horrible things to him. And so I appreciated that, and I think that it is helping me to be a better person. So Jane from Jane of Lantern Hill desperately wants a second chance for her parents, a chance to be part of a family where both of her parents are present. What's a book that you DNF'd but connected with when you gave it a second chance? And this, you've probably heard me mention before, my favorite novel, The Scorpio Races by Maggie Stiefvater. So I read this just, I started it a few months after it first came out. It released in October of 2011. And I think I tried to read it in like January of 2012, right after I had just read her Wolves of Mercy Falls trilogy. And I don't think I got past like chapter one. I read the prologue and maybe chapter one and thought, this is not for me. I'm not gonna do this. And so I stopped and never thought that I would go back to it. And then in 2017, I think it was, I randomly kind of came across the audiobook and decided to try it on audio and fell in love with it. And now I've read it 20 times. I'm sitting next to a shelf that's full of copies of it in a variety of languages, and I just love it and connect with it a lot. We have Marigold from Magic for Marigold. So Marigold is one of the few Montgomery protagonists who we only experience in childhood. She's very imaginative and loves the outdoors. What were some of your favorite things to do as a child? If you had a favorite childhood book that fed your imagination, please share that as well. So I loved being outdoors when I was little. I still like the outdoors quite a lot, but we went camping a lot when I was little. Me with some of my older siblings and things. So we went camping a lot. I remember spending a lot of time in the woods, just exploring and going and seeing all these little creeks and stuff in our the woods by our house. So we spent a lot of time in the woods, stargazing also. I remember we would go out and we lived in the country. And we could just go out and kind of lay and stargaze at night, and I loved doing that. Now we read a lot when I was little, but I don't specifically remember a lot of the books that we read. But when I was 10 is when the first Harry Potter movie came out that year, and I remember getting into the Harry Potter books and then, you know, kind of play acting being at Hogwarts. And I would do a lot of that outside too, with my siblings and things. So that was a lot of fun. But a lot of outdoor activities. We have Aunt Becky from A Tangled Web. So Aunt Becky is the matriarch of the Penhallow Dark family, who causes quite a stir over who she will leave her prized heirloom jug to. So tell us about a book you've read that has a lot of family drama. So I decided to mention one of my favorite authors, and that is Dostoevsky. He has a lot of family drama within his books. Specifically, I'm thinking about The Idiot, Devils, and the Brothers Karamazov. So in The Idiot, the main character is kind of somewhat related to a family that he ends up meeting near the beginning and getting to know. And there's a lot of drama with their family and various things that happen with them. And then in Devils, multiple of the older characters, their children, are some of the main focal points. So we get to see some of this interaction and how they view each other and why they may or may not get along. And so there's quite a bit of drama surrounding that. And then in The Brothers Karamazov, it is about brothers who all have been, there's three brothers, and they've kind of been like estranged from each other. Two of them are full siblings, and then one of them is a half brother. And so it's about their interactions with their father and all of the crazy that's involved in that family. So there's a lot of drama surrounding their family and their interaction with their father and with each other, and it's really fascinating. Now our last thing is just to tag some people. So I'm going to tag a few people. If you've been tagged by other people, then please feel free to just ignore this, but I hope that you will do some of these questions, answer some of these questions. So I would like to tag Kelly from Kelly Reads a Lot, who also loves LM Montgomery. And I would like to tag Rebecca from Reading with Rebecca Nicole, who I'm not sure actually if Rebecca has read LM Montgomery, but I think she would have some good answers for the questions. And then Courtney from Tangible Reads, also not sure if Courtney has read LM Montgomery, but I think that you could have some fascinating answers to these questions. And then the little attic library, and I don't know your name except your channel name, but she is newer on YouTube and I know loves LM Montgomery. So if you get a chance, I would also love for you to do this tag as well. So I'm going to tag those people. If you would like to do this tag and have not been tagged by anybody, then please feel free to do it and let me know, and I would love to hear your answers. If you would like to chat about any of my answers or leave answers to any of the questions in the comments, then I would love to talk with you about them there. And I will be back soon with another video.